Here's how, in a matter of months, Donald Trump has undermined and corrupted our most popular government agency.
The Postal Service is a joke.
A top donor to President Trump and the Republican National Committee has been named, wait for it, the new head of the Postal Service.
Louis DeJoy will take over the agency in mid-June. DeJoy is a fundraiser for the Republican National Convention.
The Postal Union is now raising the alarm about an intentional slowdown in mailing centers across the country.
There's growing concern the Trump administration is working to degrade the Postal Service ahead of the expected surge in mail-in ballots for the November election.
He is doing his best to undermine our confidence in the process, but worse, he's doing his best to actually steal the vote.
Since Louis DeJoy was named Postmaster General, he has made dangerous changes to the Postal Service, changes that make it harder for Americans to get their Social Security checks, to get prescriptions, and to get ballots so they can vote by mail. So who is this person who's making these changes? He is a Republican mega donor, a Trump loyalist, and he is a walking conflict of interest. He and his wife own assets worth tens of millions of dollars in Postal Service competitors and contractors. That means he could have a stake in the Postal Service's decline. And Trump?
You'll never know who the winner is, but the winner's gonna be me.
He has a stake in its decline too, because he knows that if people are heard in November, he and the Republicans will lose.
Elizabeth Warren and a group of other Democratic senators have sent a letter calling for the Inspector General to look into what's going on at the U.S. Postal Service.
And that's why I've asked the Inspector General, an independent watchdog, to investigate the new Postmaster General's motives for the recent changes that he's making. I want to make sure that the Postal Service is not becoming another political tool for Donald Trump, because it sure smells like it is. Congress must take action to fund the Postal Service, to expand vote-by-mail efforts, and to fight for our right to vote safely during this pandemic. So please, join our fight to protect the Postal Service and our democracy.